We come now to our third and final look at this great chapter of the Bible, Joshua chapter 6. And as we've looked at it, we've been noticing the theme, which is God has a plan. That's the first lesson we learned from the opening five verses. When God first told Joshua to approach the great fortified, impenetrable city of Jericho, and their way to conquering it is just to march around it 6 times for 6 days, and then 7 times on the 7th day. Blow your trumpets, shout, and the walls fall down. Seems ridiculous. It seems arbitrary. It seems foolish to man, but God says to do it, and so we do it. So the first lesson we learned was God has a plan. We make application to our salvation. God has a plan for us. He tells us what to do to be saved. And even if it doesn't make sense, even if we want to question it, God has a plan. And so we do it. And that's the second lesson. God has a plan. We have to trust that plan. And so we saw from verse 6 through 16 of Joshua chapter 6 that they trusted God and they did exactly what he said. They walked around the city. They walked around the city. They walked around the city 6 times, one each day. And then on the 7th day, they walk around the city, blow the trumpet, and Joshua says, everybody scream, because the city is yours. Now we come to the verse 20 and the third and final lesson to learn, which is God has a plan, but you have to obey. You do everything up to the point of your last act of obedience, you're not going to be saved. You have to follow through with it. You have to actually obey. Verse 20, so the people shouted when the priest blew the trumpets, and it came to pass, when the people heard the shout of the trumpet, and the people shouted with a great shout, that the wall fell down flat, so that the people went up into the city, every man straight before him, and they took the city. They won, they were victorious, they beat the bad guys, all to the glory and credit of God. It was his plan. It didn't make any sense. They didn't do anything themselves to deserve it. It was by the grace of God. And that's what the first verse says, or the second verse. I've given you Jericho. It's yours. I've given it to you. Now here's what I want you to do to take it. Could anyone argue that they worked their way to salvation? That they worked their way to victory in conquering Jericho? No, you can't argue that. Because if just they had done it, they wouldn't have defeated Jericho. The walls wouldn't have fallen. But because God said to do it, and they did it, they won. Third lesson to learn. God has a plan, but you have to obey it. You can trust it all you want. You can say, I believe in God that he'll save me, all you want. But if you don't do exactly what he says, for the reason he says it, it's not going to happen. The people obeyed. They blew the trumpet, they shouted, and the walls fell down. And so they took the city. Application. God says, I want you to believe, I want you to repent, I want you to confess your faith in Christ, I want you to be baptized in water, I want you to be literally dunked in water, immersed in a pool of water, so that you're completely covered, and then risen up from the water. You do that, and I'll save you. And people will argue, now you're working your way to heaven, you're saying I have to do something to be saved. The people had to do something to win the Battle of Jericho. They had to obey God, even though the command was ridiculous. March around the city, blow a trumpet, and scream. But they did it, and they were saved. He tells me to do it, and I'll be saved. Not by my power, not by my design, not by my good works, but by the grace of God. He says to me, see, I've given you salvation. Here's what I want you to do to take it. You can't scale the wall, but you can knock it down if you obey me. Believe and be baptized. Mark 16:16. God has a plan. Trust his plan. Obey his plan. Joshua chapter 6, great chapter of the Bible. We will resume this study next month, and we will look at a New Testament chapter, Romans chapter 6, and we will see why that is also a great chapter of the Bible. Until then, thank you very much.